Hello children, how are you all? I hope you all are fine and safe. So children, welcome back to English class of class 3. So children, do you like to travel? Yes? So what are the modes of transport that you use for traveling and which one do you prefer? So you might be liking car, bus or what, taxi, auto rickshaw, hai na? Aur kya aap istemal karte hain? मोटरसाइकिल और आप लोग बोलेंगे कि साइकिल. ओके, ये सब तो हो गए नियर बाय प्लेसेस में जाने के लिए. व्हाट आर द मोड्स ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट दैट यू यूज फॉर ट्रैवलिंग फार अवे प्लेसेस लाइक व्हेन यू वांट टू गो टू मेलन? यू विल यूज आइदर फ्लाइट और शिप्स, है ना. कैन यू ट्रैवल बाय कार? कैन यू ट्रैवल बाय कार टू अप टू मेलन? नो. सो यू कैन ट्रैवल इट बाय एरोप्लेन और by ship. So children, let us talk about a vehicle or mode of transport that does not run on road. Instead, it runs on track. Any guesses? You guessed it right. What else? It carries many freight cars also. So children, let us talk about trains today in our poem Trains, written by Sir James Tippett. So let's go through the poem. So children, as I told you, today we will be going through a poem on trains. Let's start. Trains. Over the mountains, over the plains, over the rivers, here come the trains. Carrying passengers, carrying mail, bringing their precious loads in without fail. Thousands of freight cars all rushing on, through day and darkness, through dusk and dawn. Over the mountains, over the plains, over the rivers, here come the trains. Let's repeat. Over the mountains, over the plains, over the rivers, here come the trains. Carrying passengers, carrying mail, bringing their precious loads in without fail. Thousands of freight cars all rushing on, through day and darkness, through dusk and dawn. Over the mountains, over the plains, over the rivers, here come the trains. So children, as you can see here, this is train and this is freight car. जिसे हम हिंदी में क्या कहते हैं? मालगाड़ी, है ना. ये हो गया ट्रेन आपका, रेलगाड़ी और ये मालगाड़ी. तो आज हम जो पोम पढ़ेंगे वो है ट्रेन्स के बारे में. ओवर द माउंटेन्स, ओवर द प्लेन्स. सो वेर आर द प्लेसेस वेयर ट्रेन रन्स? ओवर द माउंटेन्स यानी पहाड़ों के ऊपर से, एंड ओवर द प्लेन्स, प्लेन यानी लेवल जमीन, है ना, जहां समतल एकदम लेवल हो, उसके भी ऊपर से, केव के ऊपर से या केव के साइड से, पहाड़ों के ऊपर से. और ओवर द रिवर्स, यहाँ आप देखिए एक रिवर दिख रहा है आपको, ट्रेन उसके भी ऊपर से आते हैं. कैसे? अब आप सोच रहे होंगे कि ट्रेन नदी के ऊपर से कैसे आएगा. ब्रिजेस देखा आपने, पुल, उसके ऊपर से ट्रेन आता है. तो रिवर्स को क्रॉस करके ट्रेन वहां से भी आता है. हियर कम द ट्रेन, देखो ट्रेन आ रहा है. कैरिंग पैसेंजर्स, कैरिंग मेल. अब बताइए, आपने देखा है कि ट्रेन क्या क्या लाता है अपने साथ? पैसेंजर्स. पैसेंजर्स यानी हम यात्रीगण, है ना, यात्री लोग जो उस ट्रेन से यात्रा करते हैं, पैसेंजर्स कहते हैं उसे. और कैरिंग मेल, मेल यानी डाक. ट्रेन में पैसेंजर्स भी आते हैं और मेल्स भी. उसके बाद ब्रिंगिंग देयर प्रीशियस लोड्स. प्रीशियस यानी कीमती, कीमती सामान. वो कीमती सामान क्या है जो ट्रेन ला रहा है अभी? वो है पैसेंजर्स और मेल. इन विदाउट फेल, और बिना चुके, समय पे. आपने देखा है कभी रेलवे स्टेशन पे अनाउंसमेंट होते हुए कि इतने समय, इतने बजे करेक्ट ये जो ट्रेन है यहां से छूट जाएगा. और बराबर समय होते ही सायरन बजता है और ट्रेन छूट जाती है. आप लोगों का भी कभी हुआ होगा कि ट्रेन छूटने वाला और आप भाग कर उसे पकड़े हैं. क्यों? क्योंकि ट्रेन जो है हमारे लिए नहीं रुकता, या किसी के लिए भी नहीं रुकता. वो अपने समय पर छूटता है और जहां उसे जाना होता है उस डेस्टिनेशन तक पहुंच जाता है. तो इन विदाउट फेल, विदाउट एनी फेल, दिस ट्रेन ब्रिंग्स पैसेंजर्स एंड मेल. थाउजेंड्स ऑफ फ्राइट कार्स, जैसे मैंने बताया फ्राइट कार्स यानी मालगाड़ी है ना, थाउजेंड्स। आपने देखा है कभी लंबा ट्रेन जाते हुए जो पूरा हर जो उसका डिब्बा होता है उसमें सिर्फ मालगाड़ी वाला डिब्बा होता है, वो पूरा फ्राइट कार हो गया। ऑल रशिंग ऑन, दिन भर थाउजेंड्स ऑफ फ्राइट कार्स, बहुत सारे मालगाड़ी यहाँ से वहां से सारे जगह जगह से सामान यहाँ एक जगह से दूसरे जगह को ले जाता है। वो कौन लेके जाता है? मालगाड़ी में, फ्राइट कार में सामान लेके जाता है ट्रेन। ऑल रशिंग ऑन थ्रू डे एंड डार्कनेस, डे एंड डार्कनेस, डे यानी दिन एंड डार्कनेस यहाँ पे नाइट को बोला गया, रात को। चाहे वो दिन हो या रात, ट्रेन कभी भी नहीं रुकता, ना ही फ्लाइट कार्स रुकते। वो दिन भर अपना सफर और रात को भी अपना सफर करते रहते हैं ताकि निर्धारित जो समय है उस पर कहाँ पहुंच जाए, वो अपने डेस्टिनेशन तक पहुंच जाए। थ्रू डस्क एंड डॉन, डस्क यानी सनसेट एंड डॉन यानी सनराइज। डस्क वो समय होता है जब सूरज डूब रहा हो और डॉन जब सूरज सवेरे सवेरे उगता है तब। ओवर द माउंटेन्स, ओवर द प्लेन्स, ओवर द रिवर्स, हियर कम द ट्रेन्स। पहाड़ों के ऊपर से, प्लेन या समतल जमीन के ऊपर से, रिवर्स के ऊपर से क्या आ रहा है? ट्रेन। देखिए आप इस चित्र में देख सकते हैं ना, यू कैन सी इन दिस पिक्चर, यू कैन सी अ ट्रेन एज वेल एज अ फ्लाइट कार कमिंग ओवर द माउंटेन्स एंड ओवर द प्लेन्स एंड दिस इज रिवर। सी हाउ द ट्रेन इज क्रॉसिंग द रिवर ऑल्सो। सो I hope you like the poem very much, children. It is very interesting poem, isn't it? So, shall we see the new words? Let's see the new words now. So, children, we have come across many new words in this poem. So, let us see the new words and its meaning. Mountain, M-O-U-N-T-A-I-N-S. Mountains yani pahad. So, yahan pe mountains diye hain. Bahut sare pahad. Jaise ki aap, you can see in this picture na. All these are mountains, पहाड़ है। P-A-S-S-E-N-G-E-R-S, passengers, passengers यानी जो यात्रा करते हैं, यात्री लोग है ना। तो they are the passengers, see they are traveling by train, R-I-V-E-R-S, rivers यानी नदी, see river, this is a river and you can see a bridge also. Suppose if a train wants to cross, then it can cross by this bridge also. Mail, M-A-I-L, mail. From this picture only you can guess what is mail. Mail yani jo bhi dark hai, letters ho sakte hain ya kuch envelope kisi ko agar achanak bhejna hai, wo sab mails. Planes, P-L-A-I-N-S, planes. As I told you children, plane means a level area, है ना? Level जमीन, समतल area, तो वो ये है। You can see plane, without any mountain, without any raised area. Dusk, D-U-S-K, dusk, dusk, and D-A-W-N, dawn. Dusk, sunset, and dawn, sunrise. See, sunset and sunrise, dusk and dawn. So children, understood new words? Let's go through the exercise now. So children, after new words, shall we see the question answers now? Let's see. Reading is fun. First question is, where do the trains run? Trains kahan kahan chalte hain? As we saw in the poem, trains run over the mountains, over the plains and over the rivers. So children, I have written the answer for you. Where do the trains run? The trains run over the mountains, over the plains and over the rivers. So shall we see the next question now? What are the precious loads that they carry? So what are the precious loads that the train carry? Let's write the answer. The precious loads are the passengers and mails that they carry. So, the precious loads are the passengers and mails that they carry. So, what are the precious loads? It is passengers and mails. So, let's see the third question now. Now, the third question is, when do the trains run? Trains kab chalte hai? As we have seen in the poem, the trains run through day and darkness. That means the train runs through day and night. So, shall we write the answer now? The trains run through day and darkness. Next question is, what is dusk and dawn? As I told you, dusk means the time of sunset and dawn means the time of sunrise. Let's write. As it is given in inverted commas, so I will also write it inverted commas. Dusk means the time around sunset. Dawn means the time around sunrise. So let's repeat once. When do the trains run? The trains run through day and darkness. What is dusk and dawn? Dusk means the time around sunset and dawn means the time around sunrise. So let's move on to the next exercise now. Now children, here is talk time. Do you enjoy train rides? Now tell me children, do you enjoy train rides? Do you like traveling in trains? Yes? If you had to travel over a long distance, how would you like to go and why? As I told you, suppose if you have to go to a very far place, will you like going in car? No, you will get tired. And with aeroplane, you will reach far but you won't enjoy. But if you travel by train, then you can enjoy, play and as well as enjoy traveling, see various places. In the flight, you cannot see anything outside. Can you see trees, people and various stations? No. But when you travel by train, you can see different places and different areas with different people. And you can see people at the stations also. So, if you had to travel over a long distance, how would you like to go? We would like to go in a train. And why? Because while traveling in train, you can reach fast at the same time, enjoy also. If you had to spend the night on a train, what would you need to take with you? Suppose, if we had to go to a very far place, it might take 2 or 3 days also. And if you had to spend a night on a train, what would you need to take? You would need a torch, then you can keep a pillow, a bed sheet, and what else? Water, food, etc. What are Your needs you can keep with you. And brush also. Brush, toothpaste, towel, soap. Because early in the morning when you rise up, you will need all that also. Draw and name the things you would need in this suitcase. So you can see a suitcase here. You have to draw all that things here. जो भी आपको काम में आने वाले हैं, जो रात को एक रात आपको ट्रेन में बिताना है, अगले दिन या उस रात को आपका क्या जरूरत होगा, उन सभी चीजों के चित्र को आपको यहाँ इस सूटकेस के अंदर बनाना है. ओके चिल्ड्रन, लेट्स सी द नेक्स्ट वन. नाउ इट इज लेट्स राइट. डिस्क्राइब एन इंटरेस्टिंग ट्रेन और बस जर्नी यू हैव टेकन or would you like to take. Write four sentences about your journey. You can use some of the following words and phrases. So what you have to do, you have to describe about your past journey in a train or a bus. Or would like to take. Suppose you have not traveled by train or bus, you can imagine. Write four sentences about your journey. You will write four sentences about that journey. You can use some of the following words and phrases. Some words and phrases have been given here. You have to use these words and rewrite the sentences using these words. Example is given, I went to the railway station with my father. Then what happened? You have to write. See children, I have written few sentences using these words only. First one is, I went to the railway station with my father. I saw many people at the stations. I saw crowded tea stalls at stations. I enjoyed watching small and big trees from window seat. The train made loud whistle. So children, you can add many more sentences using these words. I have written only four. You can write many more. Okay, shall we go to the next one? So here is word building exercise. Sort out these different means of transport into correct groups. One is done for you. See, there are three groups: land, air and water. Now what are the options? Bus, car, aeroplane, ship, boat, train, bicycle, helicopter, truck and steamer. So what are the modes of transport that travel on land and the things that travel on air and that travel on water? So first let us take bus. So children, bus travel on land, air or water? Bus jo hai zameen par chalti hai, air yani aasman mein chalti hai ya water pani mein chalti hai? So bus travels on land. So we have written bus here. Next one is car. Car again travels on land. Hawa mein ya pani mein to nahi chalti hai car. So hum car ko we will write under land. Next one is aeroplane. Aeroplane yani plane jo kahan udti hai plane? Aap sabhi ko pata hai na plane kahan udti hai? Aasman mein. To aeroplane travels on air. Aeroplane. Ship travel on water. So ships travel on water. Next one is boat. Boat again, it travels on water. So we will write boat here. Next one is train. As I told you, train does not travel on road, but it travels on land. Train जो है road में नहीं चलती, जैसे bus, car, auto rickshaw वगैरह चलते हैं, तो train road में नहीं चलते, लेकिन वो जमीन पर तो चलते हैं. किसके ऊपर चलते हैं? Track. So train also runs on land. So we will write train here. Bicycle, जिसमें कितने व्हील होंगे? दो. तो वो कहाँ चलते हैं? लैंड. सो बाइसाइकिल ऑल्सो रन्स ऑन लैंड. बाइसाइकिल. नेक्स्ट वन इज हेलीकॉप्टर. आपने देखा है हेलीकॉप्टर? एरोप्लेन जितना लंबा नहीं होता है, Helicopter is smaller in size and only few people can sit. So helicopter also travels on air. So we will write helicopter here. Next one is truck. Truck kisme chalte hai? Land. So we will write truck here. Last one is steamer. Steamer यानी एक प्रकार का बोट है, शिप जैसे. देखिए steamer. So children, I have arranged few pictures. Let us see. So this is train. Here you can see helicopter. जिसने भी helicopter नहीं देखा है, you can see here. देखिए this is helicopter. Steamer. This is steamer. Bicycle and truck. So let us revise once. What are the things that travel on land? Bus, car, train, bicycle, truck. And the mode of transport that travels on air: aeroplane and helicopter. And pani mein kya chalta hai? Water that runs in water. Ship, boat and steamer. So children, I hope you will be writing all this in your notebook also. Along with the question answers, you will write all this in the notebook. And I hope you have understood also. Let us see another interesting exercise. Complete the sentences. So you have to complete the sentences using options given in the bracket. Give me some dash to eat. So give me some. Food will come or clothes will come? Which one is correct? As you know, clothes, we cannot eat clothes. We can only wear clothes. So, give me some food to eat. So, we will write food here. F-O-O-D, food. So, give me some food to eat. Next one is play with dash, me or Gray. Play with me. Mere saath khelo, hai na? To play with me. Gray is a color. Swim across dash. Kiske paar tarna hai? River ya boat? Swim across the river. So swim across the river. Let's get on the dash. Get on yani chadna. आप किस में चढ़ेंगे? ट्रेन या डॉन? डॉन यानी मैंने बताया था ना, डॉन यानी सनराइज. सनराइज या ट्रेन, आप किस में चढ़ेंगे? लेट्स गेट ऑन द ट्रेन. सो वी विल राइट ट्रेन हियर. लेट्स रिपीट. गिव मी सम फूड टू ईट. प्ले विद मी. स्विम अक्रॉस द रिवर. लेट्स गेट ऑन the train. So let's move on. So now it's fun time. Paper fun. आपको क्या करना है? You have to make a rocket like this. ये तो आप सभी लोग करते ही हैं. Paper फाड़ के notebook से आप लोग क्या करते हैं? Rocket बना के class में उड़ाते हैं. तब आपको teacher मना करते हैं. लेकिन अब now today I am telling you to make paper rockets. See how to make. These are the procedure of making a paper rocket. So after making the rocket, आप क्या करेंगे? उसे क्लास में उड़ाएंगे. Crouch low, then rise. Take off and move around the room. Come down like a rocket and dance too. आपको क्या करना है? ये पेपर रॉकेट बनाकर आपको क्राउच करना है. नीचे बैठ के क्राउच करना है. उसके बाद then rise. उसके बाद उठना है. Take off. आप पेपर को उड़ाएंगे. एंड मूव अराउंड द रूम. आपको रूम में घूमना है. जब वो रॉकेट नीचे आएगा तो उसके बाद आपको डांस करना है. अप 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 इन अ रॉकेट. अप वी विल गो. अप वी विल गो. अप 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 इन अ रॉकेट. अवे अप हाई विल गो. शैल वी रिपीट. अप 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 इन अ रॉकेट. अप वी विल गो. अप वी विल गो. Up, up, up in a rocket, away, up, high will go. Okay? Let's move to the next one. So it is say aloud. Here what you have to do, you have to repeat after me. Just repeat after I say. Mail, dawn, planes, fail, on, trains. Mail, dawn, planes, fail, on and trains. Next is a very interesting poem, a small rhyme. Let's sing. Engine, engine number 9. Engine, engine number 9. When she's polished, she'll shine. Engine, engine number 9. 10 will ride on the Shimla line. Shall we repeat? Engine, engine number 9. Engine, engine number 9. When she's polished, she will shine. Engine, engine number 9. 10 will ride on the Shimla line. Very interesting, isn't it? So this is the end of our today's poem. It was a very nice poem. Trains, about trains we have seen. And I hope you have enjoyed the poem. You'll be writing the question answer also. And we have gone through few exercises also. That also you have understood, I hope. And so we will meet in the next chapter. Till then, take care. Stay safe. Bye-bye.